I think the main project goal of UWE at Harvard is to be able to work on real-world projects while also bolstering the engineering education.
Yeah, over this coming school year, just looking forward to making more progress on this distribution network. So previously we constructed two boreholes in the community, just like individual, I guess, like really deep wells. One of them is like 120 meters into the ground, the other one is 60 meters into the ground. Over the next year, hopefully we're going to create the design networks to install piping from our last borehole to like a huge central tank that can hold hundreds of thousands of gallons of water, and then connect that tank to a few different water kiosks throughout the community.
Definitely one of my favorite has been going on one of the implementation trips and getting to see the progress that we've made on the project and sort of like have all the work that we do throughout the club come to life.
And I think the thing that was most valuable for me in traveling was getting to talk directly to the community members. So everything has been through WhatsApp, through Zoom previously. And I do speak Spanish, so being able to go house to house and help with surveys and talk firsthand, what are the issues you face now with your current water system? What would you like for the future water system?
We were originally hoping for a flow rate of like, let's say 1 to 2 cubic meters per hour, which is like a pretty good flow rate. People can, you know, use a hand pump, collect water that way. But we actually got about closer to 5 or 6 cubic meters per hour. So that was really surprising. And it's really great because now we can think about sending this water to other places in the community. This is just so much water that it doesn't even make sense to just do a hand pump. We can actually install an electric pump.
And we were not sure if they were going to directly connect this water to the storage tank and then kind of feed it through the system, or if they just wanted taps running, or if they were going to create a tap stand, because we really didn't know what their preference was. We could only speculate. So to hear exactly, like, this is how I want it to be constructed within my house, you just give me that T connection on the main road and this is what I will do with it, was super, super helpful for the distribution system and very informative in terms of checking the pressures that we need at the endpoints, knowing what that specifically, how that will be used.
Most of the professional workforce will step into an existing project and leave an existing project. For most of our students, they very much experience that as part of the Humanitarian Design Projects course. And as a result, it makes them document their work in a way that their successors have to be able to pick up and learn from it. Just like when they step in, they need to learn from their predecessors. So creating a course structure around the design outcomes for the Engineers Without Borders projects increased the level of accountability. And it really created a framework where the participants took the work to the next level. And over the course of the past several years, this is shown in the water and housing projects that we've been able to implement in the Dominican Republic and Tanzania and Kenya.